गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई विल टीच यू चैप्टर यूजिंग ऑफलाइन ब्लॉग एडिटर्स। इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर यू हैव लर्न हाउ क्रिएट अ ब्लॉग विच रिक्वायर्स अ प्लेटफॉर्म एंड एन इंटरनेट कनेक्शन, बट डू यू नो दैट यू कैन क्रिएट योर ब्लॉग्स इन एन ऑफलाइन मोड यूजिंग अ ब्लॉग एडिटर विच कैन लेट बी पब्लिश्ड वेन एवर इंटरनेट कनेक्टिविटी इज अवेलेबल। Offline blog editor. An offline blog editor is a tool to create blog posts without an internet connection. To create an offline blog, you need to have an offline blog editor. Several offline blog editors are available which you can download and install on your computer system. An offline blog editor is an amazing tool for bloggers because it lets you create blog posts without an internet connection. So instead of waiting to wait for an online editor to load and then worry that a hiccup in your network connection could cancel out all your work, you can just work offline. Offline editors let you create, edit and format your content before you upload it to your website. Then if you have an internet connection, you can publish the post directly to your blog. So students, here you can see different types of offline blog editor. First, Windows Live Writer. Windows Live Writer is, as you might guess from its name, Windows compatible and owned by Microsoft. Windows Live Editor is rich in features and very easy to use, and you can even add enhanced functionality with free Windows Live Writer plugins. Now for which kind of application you need to support: WordPress, Blogger, Typepad, Movable Type, Live Journals and others. Next is BlogDesk. BlogDesk is also free and can be used on Windows as your offline blog editor, because BlogDesk is a WYSIWYG editor, means what you see is what you get editor. You can clearly see what your post will look like when you are done editing it. Supports WordPress, Movable Type, Drupal, Expression Engine and Serendipity. Qmana, Windows and Mac. So this kind of blog editor, means Qmana, is for Windows and Mac computers, and it works with the most common blogging applications. What sets Qmana apart from most other offline blogging software is integrated feature that makes it very easy to add advertising to your blog post. Next, Marsh Edit for Mac system. Meant for Mac computers, Marsh Edit is another blog editor for offline use. The price is not going to break the bank, but do test Marsh Edit as well as a free alternative before you commit to paying anything. Overall, Marsh Edit is one of the most comprehensive offline blog editors for Mac users. Ecto. This is also for Mac users. Ecto for Macs is easy to use and offers a lot of features, but the price deters some bloggers from using it, particularly when there are less expensive options available that offer similarly functionality. However, Ecto is a good and reliable tool that works with several popular and even some uncommon blogging platforms. BlogJet Windows means BlogJet for Windows user. another Windows blog editor with lots of features that you can use offline is Blogjet. If you have a WordPress, MoveIt type or TypePad blog, Blogjet lets you create and edit pages for your blog right from your desktop. The program is what you see is what you get editor, so you don't need to know HTML. It also has a spell checker, full Unicode support, Flickr and YouTube supports, auto draft capability and word counter and lots of other blog specific features that you can read about on the Blogjet homepage. Next, Bits for Mac system. Bits doesn't support a wide variety of blogging platform like the other programs from this list, but it does let you write offline blog posts right from your Mac. Next, Microsoft Word for Windows as well as Mac system also. Everyone knows that Microsoft Word can be used offline, so it is a given that it can be used to build blog posts. However, did you know that you can also use Word to publish your blog post directly to your blog? You can purchase Microsoft Office, which includes Word and other MS Office programs like Excel and PowerPoint. If you already have MS Word on your computer, see Microsoft help page on how to use it with your blog. However, we don't recommend purchasing MS Word just to use it as an offline blogging etiquette. If you already have Word, then go ahead and try it out for yourself. But if not, go with one of the free cheaper option. Now in this chapter, you will learn about online transaction and e-shopping. First, I will discuss about here, what is e-shopping? E-shopping is a form of electronic commerce which allows consumers to directly buy goods or services from a seller over the internet. It has been gaining popularity over the last few years because people find it convenient and easy to shop from the comfort of their homes. They do not have to wait in long queues or search from store to store for a particular item. They can compare the products easily and get good bargains online. E-shopping sites. Here you can see e-shopping sites. E-commerce was first introduced in the 1960s via an electronic data interchange. With the increased availability of internet access, e-commerce activity have increased. More and more online sellers came into the picture in the 1990s and early 2000s. Advantages of e-shopping for the customers. Shopping online can be carried out 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, all the year round. You can do online shopping from the convenience of your home without the need to travel to shops. All details of the products are often listed on websites. The customer can shop whenever it is convenient. Disadvantages of e-shopping for the customer. A customer can only see an image of the product and is unable to touch or feel it. Products may not exactly match the images shown on the site. A person, or you can say a salesman or salesperson, is unavailable to answer the queries of the customer. If the customer wants to return a product, the process may be quite tedious. Customers should be careful while doing online transaction. There are chances online frauds, and so they must take appropriate security measures. Now we will discuss about online transaction using Flipkart. Here you can see Flipkart symbols. Flipkart is an e-commerce company founded by Sachin Bansal and Vinny Bansal in 2007. Through Flipkart, you can purchase a variety of books, clothes, necessities, digital cameras, mobile phones, etc. Flipkart offers multiple payment methods like credit card, debit card, net banking, e-gift voucher, and cash on delivery. First, what will you do? Open any browser and log on to the official website of Flipkart by typing in www.flipkart.com. Next, either you can type the name of the item you want to search in the search box at the top, or you can search for item by selecting the appropriate categories just below the search option. You will a list of item in the option selected. Select the item by clicking on it. When you hover the mouse on the selected item, you will see the full image of that particular item. You will also find the description and specification of the item along with its price next to the image. So students, here you can see how will you your transaction money using Flipkart. Okay, here you can also see few points. Flipkart makes payment separately from both these accounts. The payment is credited to your bank account only if there is a positive balance in these two accounts. It may not be out of place to mention that the balance may be negative as well due to returns, etc. The settlement amount is the total order item value minus Flipkart marketplace fee. Now we will talk about e-reservation. E-reservation. So now there you can see different mode or method for reserving your seat. So there are many other application areas which help you plan your travel, gather information about the place you want to visit, and book your holiday tours, hotels, train and flight tickets online. Online transaction. You have to open browser and log on to the official website Redbus, www.redbus.in. Sign up to register, create an account, select from and to onward that date and return date. If required, click on search buses. You will get a list of available buses on the journey date, the timing, available seats and the fares. मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, नेक्स्ट चैप्टर इज व्हाट इज नेटवर्क सिक्योरिटी। नेटवर्क सिक्योरिटी इज अ ब्रॉड टर्म दैट कवर्स अ मल्टीट्यूड ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजीज, डिवाइसेस एंड प्रोसेसेस। इन इट्स सिंपल टर्म इट इज अ सेट ऑफ रूल्स एंड कॉन्फ़िगरेशन डिजाइन टू प्रोटेक्ट द इंटेग्रिटी, कॉन्फिडेंशियलिटी and accessibility of computer networks and data using both software and hardware technology. Next, there are different types of network security. Physical network security. Physical security controls are designed to prevent unauthorized personnel from gaining physical access to network components such as router, cabling, cupboards and so on. Controlled access such as locks, biometric authentication and other devices is essential in any organization. Technical network security. Technical security controls protect data that is stored on the network or which is in transit across into or out of the network. Protection is twofold. It needs to protect data and system from unauthorized personnel, and it also needs to protect against malicious activities from employees. Administrative network security. Administrative security controls consist of security policies and processes that controls user behavior, including how users are authenticated, their level of access, and also how IT staff members implement changes to the infrastructure. Types of network security. Network access control, antivirus, anti-malware software, firewalls protection, virtual private network. First, I will start from network access control. To ensure that potential attackers cannot infiltrate your network, comprehensive access control policies need to be in place for both users and devices. Network access control can be set at the most granular level. For example, you could grant administrators full access to the network but deny access to specific confidential folders or prevent their folders device from joining the network. Antivirus software. Antivirus and anti-malware software protect an organization from a range of malicious software including viruses, ransomware, worms and trojans. The best software not only scan files upon entry to the network but continuously scans and tracks files. Firewall protection. Firewalls, as their name suggests, act as a barrier between the untrusted external networks and your trusted internal network. Administrators typically configure a set of defined rules that blocks or permits the traffic onto the network. Virtual private network. Antivirus and anti-malware software protect an organization from a range of malicious software including viruses, ransomware, worms and trojans. Firewalls, as their name suggests, act as a barrier between the untrusted external networks and your trusted internal network. Administrators typically configure a set of defined rules that blocks or permit traffic onto the network. वर्चुअल नेटवर्क वर्चुअल प्राइवेट नेटवर्क क्रिएट अ कनेक्शन टू द नेटवर्क फ्रॉम अनदर एंड पॉइंट और साइट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल यूजर्स वर्किंग फ्रॉम होम वुड टिपिकली कनेक्ट टू द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन नेटवर्क ओवर अ वीपीएन. Data between the two points is encrypted and other would need to authenticate to allow communication between their device and the network.